This is Satay Kajang. It's called Satay Kajang Haji Samuri. It's in a plus or in the highway shop lots. It's next to the highway. And it's for one person and it's heavy as F. Holy shit, it's heavy. Oh, and they have a lot of branches. Oh my god, there's like 1, 2, I thank god it count for me. 20 branches, oh my god. 22 branches. It's a successful franchise. Satay. How much is this? Huh? Went up in price.
It used to be 70 cents, right?
70 cents per stick,
yeah.
Of chicken satay.
Now it's 98.
Wow. 80 cents becomes 1 ringgit. 1 ringgit is equivalent to, let's see, 25 US cents. Now, 1 stick of chicken satay or satay chicken. That's what, oh yes, that's the example I wanted to make. Satay chicken, chicken satay, which one is it? I get confused when so it's 1 ringgit per stick of chicken satay chicken. And it's equivalent to 25 US cents. Let's see here. This is too much actually. How much is... Oh, the money is here actually. What should I ask? Wait a minute. This is only the satay chicken, which is 10 ringgit. That means it's 10 sticks. Yeah, 10 ringgit. 10 ringgit is roughly about 2 US dollars and 50 US cents. Yeah. $2 and 50 US cents in this contraption here. Yep, 10 of it. It's gonna be sweet, of course. And it looks like a Cornetto ice cream. I'm laughing because I think I lost my SD card. I think I need to go everywhere in the nooks and crannies of this house in search of the black SD card into Jaden's toys. I'm not sure. I've never lost the SD card until here, miraculously. Point the finger, of course, must be towards the one who has the itchy finger. Oh my god, the satay is so much.
What's that?
It's quite a lot of satay just for 10 sticks. Holy shit. That's a lot of sugar. Lot. Oh, thank you very much.
Hey, this one,
Do
you see this thing?
No, I did not read. I used the cloth that is next to the balcony door instead to wipe the three black reclining seats. Seats that can go up and down. I wash them already with soap. Soap lah, because it's oily one. Here it got grime.
You washed it?
No. Use the white with a brush. And what are these satay, not satay, these nasi lemak, is it for you tomorrow?
No.
For me also? What the hell? You think I'm fat, man? Oh, these ones here are wrapped in banana leaf, I think. Yeah, banana leaf. So I'm gonna have that tomorrow. So I'm gonna eat this today. Yes. So cucumber, it comes with. But where are the onions? Bloody hell, no onions. Not good. Bad review. No onions. Onions is good for kissing girls after. So dump it in. Because it's mixed with the heat of the satay chicken. Chicken satay. Satay chicken. Which one is it? So lovely job, please. Something to do with breasts. So these ones here, I'm not sure how much. No idea. But these ones here, satay kajang, 10 ringgit. 2 US dollars and 50 US cents. Quite expensive. Normally you should be able to buy 2 meals with 10 ringgit. But this one is all chicken. Which is delicious. Chicken is delicious. Tea does not come with it. So the nasi lemak costs about 2 ringgit, that means it's about 50 US cents. 50 US cents times 4 is 2 ringgit, right? Yep, 2 ringgit. So I have one tomorrow, which is I'm going to put in the fridge. And I'm going to take maybe 5 sticks and half of this satay sauce. Of course, the satay sauce would definitely make me full. So, all in all, let's say 5 sticks means 5 ringgit. 2 ringgit here, that means 7 ringgit. 7 ringgit is close to 8 ringgit. 8 ringgit is $2, so close to less than $2 to have 5 sticks of chicken satay that comes with satay sauce, which is a lot here. Crazy, man. There's a lot of protein in here because it's made out of many, many grounded nuts who gave their lives to make this awesome sauce, which of course knowing it is from Satay Kajang at Lebuh Raya Shah Alam. That means Shah Alam, which is a place, and Lebuh Raya means highway. So Shah Alam Highway, along the Shah Alam Highway. So this is, yep, half of it. I'm going to eat half of it, I'm going to drink it down, gulp it down, definitely. And as I said earlier, Satay Kajang, their satay sauce is a bit sweeter than usual. It's full of sugar and of course you would just love it. And this is just nasi lemak, literally translated as fatty rice. Nasi is rice and lemak means fat, so fatty rice. Therefore, it's the rice portion, the meat portion, and the protein portion, which is a lot of oil and sugar and peanut. Peanut is full of oil, right? People who are vegetarians, they need to eat something peanutty or something that's like a peanut to get their protein needs that is needed for their body. And the body needs protein to do all types of stuff like build muscles, make sperm if you're a guy, and other fun stuff. So let's get on cracking and eat this thing. So should I leave the satay sticks? I'm only going to eat half of it and leave it for tomorrow to put into the...
Are you going to make it?
What?
I always put sticks and mine.
I'm talking about the satay.
I'm talking about the water.
Should I put the satay, leave it in this cornetto ice cream drumstick thing? Configuration. How in the world do you actually do this?
Yeah, then go and see what your brother is doing.
Ah, lovely.
Let's see what your brother is doing.
Lovely, lovely, lovely.
Huh?
2 rubber bands.
Hey, Dad. Huh? Let's see what your brother is doing.
Wow. Sugar, lots of, whoa, strong stuff. It's not spicy, it's more rich and, oh, this time they are not stingy with the satay sauce. Strange, and sometimes it's stingy, sometimes it's not. You ask them to give more.
Today I was the third person there to buy.
You mean there were two others at the time of your being there?
Just open.
That means really you are the third person. So you get more. They have tons of it around. Okay.
There's my...
So let's open up the cornetto. It's a lot, you know, the sauce. Holy shit. With all the weight. No.
Okay.
Who knows lah. So cornetto, open up. Take a look what's inside. Plastic, normally there will be a plastic bag inside this thing. Wow, it's small. Normally it's not, does not look like a cornetto ice cream cone. But this is only 10, so not many. So it's able to become a cornetto.
Look like the one.
What?
Fire.
So it's in a plastic bag with the yellow sauce. What's this yellow sauce?
You don't want to put in the fish, huh?
Put it. You can have it if you want to in the nasi lemak. So let's take 5 of it out.
You want not? Huh? You want to take more?
No. No. I'm not a pig. So, yep, that's the satay chicken sticks. Let's put it back in this cornetto encasing for tomorrow.
This one don't for me,
Chong.
This one.
Take
here. This one chong, I have 2 go. You
know, this chong. Got bored with chong already. Mommy made a lot of chong.
Yeah.
A lot. Go back. Go ahead. So put this back inside the fridge. Oh, yeah.
Hey, how come they never give onions? Ah, no onions. Hello.
Oh.
Oh, they don't lah. Why? Very difficult to chop. Same as cucumber.
Probably.
Cucumber can be left for tomorrow, right?
No. What? Better to eat it now.
Yeah. Before it turns watery, is it?
Mm.
Okay. So, a lot of cucumber, a lot of vegetables. No, it's not a vegetable, it's actually a...
Is it a tomato or fruit? Something or something?
Sweet!
No, a lot of like, serai.
Serai is with the... smothered with the... I think they use the serai as a brush. So they take the yellow oil and brush it on the burning or charcoaling or barbecuing chicken. Right?
Yep.
That's why there's a strong serai smell to it. Serai is lemongrass. Serai is the Malay word for lemongrass. Just in case you're wondering what the fuck is I'm talking about. What did I say? So that's my food. And nasi lemak, of course. Here. Let's open it up. Nasi lemak fatty rice. We have a banana leaf, which is quite rare nowadays. They normally use a plastic bag instead of this very... Ooh. Okay, I think I know what this nasi lemak or fatty rice is about. It's more like glutinous rice already. I can see it's quite glutinous-y. So, you got the egg, then the sambal, which sambal means curry sauce made out of onions, belacan, chili, and sugar and salt and whatever. And so some of this fried peanuts and fried anchovies there. So let's go and chomp and see what it tastes like. You sure you don't want any more satay sauce?
Nope.
Okay. So I got my seat, which I cleaned today. Yeah, I cleaned the seat today. It was full of grime. What do you call scum, is it? When you mix oil with dust, what do you get? What? No, you don't know. Stubborn. Very stubborn. Very stubborn dust.
Grime.
Okay, it's called grime. So this is the cucumber. Slightly cold because I brought it out of the fridge, of course. So let's taste some of this lovely satay sauce, which is one of the complaints normally I have when it comes to this Satay Kajang. Is the sauce is a bit too. I would love to have the peanuts to be in crunchy mode. Or still being a bit crunchy, but it's normally very soft because they boil it or they make the satay sauce in a huge vat or a big tub or a big pot. So this is the sauce. It's nice because it's sweet, but I get a hint of tofu in it. I think they boil it so much until the satay chunks become a bit too soft and therefore it becomes a bit like tofu, and now it has the same taste as tofu, consistency the same as tofu. Don't look at me weirdly, I do taste a bit of tofu in it, kinda. Spicy tofu, awesome tofu, tofu that it has taste in it and sweet, it's an awesome tofu, because tofu normally it does not taste at all awesome to me. Huh? No, Jaden has a bad egg.
No, he wants egg. No, he sees egg, he wants egg.
Why he loves to eat egg? A lot. So let's taste this chicken here. Hopefully it's not cold anymore. Hopefully it's cooked. You can see the black charred parts. If you were in Britain or wherever, if you're not, what you call that word? If you're not a, what do you call, a hipster or whatever, hipsters are okay with the black charring of the food, but normal people, I don't think they want to eat the black stuff, the overcooked, burnt parts of the chicken, but looks fine to me. Soft. I hope there's fat that I'm eating, because if it's uncooked chicken meat, I'm a bit afraid. But don't be afraid of uncooked chicken meat, because people in Japan, they love to eat uncooked chicken meat, I think. Hopefully. So let's dip it in the sauce. Ouch. So this is a bamboo stick, I think. Lovely, with the sauce. Nice. Ah, I shouldn't have thrown away the stick. Can use the stick as a cucumber skewer. Because satay sauce and cucumber mix together nicely. So there's raw onions, raw crunchy onions. Awesome. Yummy, yummy. Jason is not eating anything. Oh, it's not for the baby. What is this tissue doing here? Can you use or not?
Didn't. Enough,
Let's dissect this nasi lemak. So some of this glutinous type rice. You know that there's been inside is enclosing for a long time already. Yeah, the rice becomes a bit too mushy. It's not bad, not bad. The anchovies are not crunchy because again, it was hot, I think, when they were bungkusing it. That's Malay word for packaging it in this softened banana leaf. No. Not yet, after I'll do so. After I'll do it. Okay. The egg, of course, would taste like egg. And the rice really turned into glutinous rice because of its own steam. You leave it for a few hours in its own steam, you turn a bit mushy. That's how nasi lemak is. You don't expect individual grains of rice from nasi lemak. Normally nasi lemak, when you leave it from morning, they start doing it and packaging it in the morning. Sometimes they leave it overnight, therefore it becomes mushy and stuck together. Still tastes quite good. And normally when you are eating nasi lemak, aka fatty rice, what you get here is going to be lukewarm or just room temperature. It's not going to be hot. But some people do sell fresh and hot nasi lemak rice that comes with rice that is steaming hot, piping hot. And the rice that accompanies the nasi lemak normally is cooked with pandan, which is a type of herb, and gives it an aroma. And also is cooked with coconut milk, aka santan. Santan is a Malay word for coconut milk. The more coconut milk they put in with the rice, the more decadent and tasty it becomes. And of course, the sambal or the curry plays a very important part in making the rice taste somewhat spicy and awesome. Awesome. Yum yum. Very nice. Let's continue on eating some cucumber slathered with satay sauce. I'm not gonna I'm not gonna defile the nasi lemak with satay sauce, because if you were to eat the satay, the nasi lemak with the satay sauce, what's the point? The nasi lemak really tastes very good by itself with a bit of sambal. You don't need to slather all your rice with something powerful or very strong in the taste and or aroma like satay sauce. You want to have all the flavors individually separated, not to be overpowered by one very powerful sauce like this satay sauce, which is awesome actually. Again, tastes like tofu, a bit of tofu to me. The reason I'm using two spoons is I don't want to use one spoon and dip it into the sauce which I'm going to use tomorrow morning for lunch. Actually, the point is moot because I'm dipping the cucumber into the sauce. So, satay. The satay sticks, chicken on skewers as they call it in Britain, served by the Chinese, it's not the same as, really not the same as the ones you get in Malaysia or Indonesia. Well, I do not know what it's like in Indonesia, but judging by the proximity of Indonesia to Malaysia, we are separated only by the sea, which is not that far away. I guess the satay that you get in Malaysia is similar to the ones you get in Indonesia, specifically Jawa or somewhere Aceh, which is the epicenter of the very huge Christmas tsunami that killed a lot of people. And now has turned into a zealot area where Muslim rules prevail and has usurped logic. Because of the mosque being spared from the tsunami. And they think it's God's will. But it's actually just geography. If the mosque was on top of a hill, of course it would be spared from the tsunami. If the cemetery was on top of a hill, of course it would be spared by the tsunami. So if a cemetery was there instead of a mosque on the hill, so will people be praying to the devil or to the ghost or to the skeletons of the graveyard? Or as the Malays or the Muslims call it, nikam. Nikam is a word for graveyard. So humans are very easily influenced, especially by religion. And of course in their hour of need, they will succumb to anything, unfortunately for geological people. The crunch and the satay sauce. Satay sauce is like soft, whereas the cucumber is crunchy and lovely to the teeth or to the movement of the mouth. I know you're going to complain that I'm talking with my mouth open. Normally when I eat, I open my mouth. It's something that I've been trying to prevent when I'm making videos. So it's hard to reprogram oneself when you're used to it since when you're young. Chicken is nice. Very nice. So the chicken skewers from my Chinese takeaway, which is called Happy Wok. There are a lot of Happy Woks in Britain, specifically Wales. Chicken is massive, man. It's three times the size of this. This is a small chicken on skewers, whereas those ones from the Chinese takeaways in Britain, huge. Maybe it's similar in all Chinese takeaways in Britain, but I remember fondly of the Happy Wok in Wales. Mm. So I'm switching from the sweetness of the satay sauce to the slightly salty nasi lemak or fatty rice here. Nice contrast. Sometimes you need yin and yang flavors, you know. Opposite flavors make one whole. Not talking about whole, H-O-L-E, W-H-O-L-E, I'm talking about. With the W, okay? Battery is running out, so I'm going to change the pack. So I don't remember I can tell you the size of the satay sticks in Britain from the Chinese takeaway. That is, I don't remember whether they have cucumbers or they serve it with something else. I don't think they serve. I can't remember specifically. Did they serve with cucumber and raw onions? I don't think so. No idea. Can't remember. Such a long time ago. 5 years ago since I left Britain. 6 years. Left Britain in 2009. Now it's 2016. June specifically. So, besides the size of the chicken, another major difference is between here and there. Here, as in Malaysia or Southeast Asia and Britain, is here is the chicken. You see the burn marks in specific areas. That means it's a bit too close to the charcoal. We barbecue the chicken skewers, whereas the Chinese takeaways in Britain, they fry it. Yep, everything's fried. So it's definitely slightly different in terms of taste. Some people might like it fried, some people might like it not fried. I do miss the aromatic duck. Aromatic duck, I never tasted it before until I went to Britain. Aromatic duck, so lovely. And I worked in a restaurant, I think it's called the Flying Condor in Oxford. In front of Oxford train station, there was a blue looking restaurant. We could actually see the steps of a building, a big building. I'm not sure what that building is, maybe it's a college. I also can see the train station. Back in 2004 or 2005, where the height of the terrorism was very high, thanks to the bombing of the train stations and also the double-decker bus. Sometimes I see a lot of police in a train station, I mean in front of the train station, Oxford train station that is. So it's quite exciting. So back then, in the restaurant, I had to serve people. Which makes me nervous to actually serve this aromatic duck, because I had to stand in front of them with my either one spoon or one fork, or both of them together, and try to scrape the duck, fried duck meat, into tiny little slivers or strands of protein or meat. Very scared of that. Normally I have my back turned to them so they can't see me. I don't do it in front of them. I should actually do it in front of them, but I was just too nervous. Of course, it's part of the experience to see it being shredded by the waiter, and this waiter, moi, was not a good waiter. I worked there for 3 months only, and the manager caught me stealing some money from the donation box. So I was very bored, so I did that, unfortunately, to spice up my life. I was asked to leave, and I ended up in a takeaway, which is a good thing, kind of. And I tried to not be naughty with money. So that's my life in Britain. Love it. You can say that I'm quite rebellious sometimes with authority. And normally you'll bring trouble to me, obviously. Nice, I just like the egg yolk. Nice egg yolk. Gives it a nice contrast, a different taste. So nice. So there you have it. You've seen me eating this satay chicken skewers or satay chicken. We don't call it satay chicken skewers. Maybe in Britain they call it chicken satay chicken skewers. But here it's just satay chicken. Yum yum. That was definitely cooked. The darker it is or the more charred it looks like, the harder it will be because it's kind of like overcooked. Better to eat something overcooked than to something something that is undercooked, which can have bacteria like salmonella and it will really fuck up your day. So, very delicious. Help me in making the next video by supporting me through Patreon. Like, subscribe, and leave a comment. Share it among your friends in Facebook and whatnot. See you. Bye bye. This is the face of an orgasming Asian.